I want to talk to you a little bit tonight. The Lord's moving, okay? And He's moving mightily. He's fixing to pour His Spirit out in greater measure in Cushing, Oklahoma. I'm just telling you that. And things are really happening, and I really felt the Lord speak to me today a little bit. We're going to begin to do some worship a little bit later, but I want you to get your mind wrapped around this tonight. Nope, I'm good, thank you. This is your life on earth. Just one look on your face. This is your life with eternity. Just one glance of your eyes. Every one of us are trying to run a race to be successful, to be at the right place at the right time, to find the right man or the right woman. Is that not right? And we're trying to make everything happen for us when we've got it all backwards. We need to be planning this with the Lord in our life so that we're ready for eternity. And I say that, and I just want to just share with a little bit about what's been going on. Tomorrow night, it's Thursday at 9 o'clock. Those that are wanting to be a part of it, you're more than welcome to come. We're going to have a 12-hour prayer vigil. We're going to pray from 9 o'clock to 9 o'clock. And I know some of you think, what are you, crazy, Pastor? No. Because let me tell you what's going on. In the last 3 days, Bruce, myself, Leon, off and on, we all be in worship, praising God. Okay? And the anointing would begin to move. Just like the anointing's moving right now, because you know why? I'm sensing it. You know why I sense it? It's because I have been practicing getting in the presence of God. How many know you could practice getting close to your girlfriend? Right? You could practice getting close to your boyfriend. But you can also practice getting close to God. And let me just tell you, I was up here one day during the week, and I was praying. And the anointing was coming so strong, and all I could do is describe about the anointing, what the anointing was doing. It was just like being in a wave pool. Anybody ever been in a wave pool? How that wave will hit you and knock you back. I mean, know what I'm talking about. Okay? That's what the anointing was doing to me. And this is a new season. I know the anointing of God. I know the presence of God. I've been around it. Praise God. God showed me some things. But this is a new season in the ministry of what God's doing. He's doing a new thing. What He's doing in Oklahoma right here, Cushing, is He's pouring out His Spirit. And He's going to pour out His Spirit on those that want it. Now remember, this is your life. Right now, there are guys, there are girls that their heartbeat is heavy for some type of man or woman in your life. There's nothing wrong with it. But if it gets out of balance and you're seeking that more than finding what the will of God is in your life for eternity, you're going to be set in a trap. Because your design being on this earth was designed by God to do the will of God and the plan of God. Now, how many understand that in the culture of the whole church, in the culture of sometimes in our families, That is not their design. They don't care to be in the design of having God in their life. Is that not correct? Okay? And that's why God's raising up men and women at the end time to begin to be men and women standing on the wall and trying to teach other people how to get into the presence of God. Okay? This is your life. I'm 55 years old. I want to tell you, I remember a time I couldn't wait until I was 18. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Oh man, I mean bigger things are going to come. I'm going to be 18. 18 shows up and 18's here and it's like, oh, that's it? Oh, well, I know it's going to be better. When I get 21, I can be of age. I can go in a bar if I want to. Okay, whoopee-doo. What's that going to do to add to your life? It does nothing for eternity. I said it does nothing for eternity. Your life's measured. Every one of your lives are measured tonight. Every one of your lives measured tonight. And whatever you're choosing along the way, it'll either make it rough or you can make it easy. I would say one thing that would make your life easy. Become a lover of the Lord. No, some of you don't know what I'm talking about. Become a lover of the Lord. That means you've got to get time in the presence of God. I thought that I got to tell this. Caitlin Azard, if I share what God spoke in prayer. I went up to Caitlin and Michaela before service. Some of you don't know this, but their papa passed away with cancer. But he was a Christian. He was born again. He went to heaven. What has it been, 6 years? Five? Not easy. It's tough when you lose someone you love. It was a great blessing. Well, didn't think about it. I didn't, wasn't planning on going that direction, but I've been praying, God, show me secrets that only you know. So be careful. God might show me a secret that might be revealed to you. Well, we're in worship. Just praising the Lord. And I told him, I said, come in here. I want to show you what Bruce and myself have been experiencing in the presence of God, the anointing of God, the waves of God, the Spirit of God. And the anointing of God began to move. Did it not? Did it begin to touch you? She said, man, I haven't felt that in a long time. In the midst of that, the word of the Lord comes to you. See, here's the thing you don't realize. You're going through a dark time. You're going through a tough time. You can't figure it out. You don't know up or down, backward, forward. You don't know where you're going. You feel like everything's against you. You feel like you're the ugly duck in the family. You feel like you're the outcast in the family. And that's because people in your lives, people, mom and dad, choose the wrong things along the way, and they don't do what God wants done. They're choosing their own way instead of trying to find out what God wants during this time. Because remember, we're going to reign and rule with God for eternity. Did you know that? Some of you haven't got it figured out yet. Some of you are still going, dude, I got this much time and I'm going to live it up while I got time. And some of us figured out, not me, man. I know for eternity, man, I can't wait to go with God. So we're in praise and worship. Go to the one song. What is it? Holy, Holy. It's on Pastor Jeff's. I think it's this one. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Are you there? No, it's not that one. Bruce, you know what? Go ahead. I want to show you some things. My job is to teach you, to show you what the presence of God. Yeah, there it is. See, instantly, I don't know if some of you are aware of it, how many instantly sense the presence of God? Anybody? Instantly on the inside of here, I was just, it's like a light switch went off, and it's like, wow, man, there's power there. Well, you say, well, Pastor, how come I'm not sensing it? Because you know why? You got your five physical senses more activated than your spirit. So you won't sense it. So we're in worship. Go ahead, turn it up just a little bit more. I just want to show you what God was doing. If you feel the presence of God, just be obedient. Don't worry what other people think, because you know what? What you choose affects your eternity, not what they choose. That's why I don't care what other people think about me. I don't care.
Just one glance.
Because what I care about is being in the presence of God for eternity of what He's called me to do. Is that not right? Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you. Now, if the anointing begins to move, you're more than welcome to come up, get in the presence, and let the Spirit begin to move. Because you know what? He loves when His people are drawn by the presence of God. He loves it. He loves it. He loves it. Because He knows it's going to affect your life on this earth for eternity. So, getting back to the story with Caleb and Caitlin. We're worshiping God. Oh, one word comes to mind. Oh, thank you, Jesus.
There's only one word to describe. Only one.
Turn it up a little bit more, brother.
Comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. Holy, Lord God Almighty, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty.
So we're worshiping, right? We're in the presence of God. Just really be attentive. All of a sudden, the Word of the Lord speaks to me in that presence. And you know what the Word of the Lord tells me? To tell Caitlin and Caleb. He says, tell them that their papa is right there with you. Because see, Papa's already in heaven with Jesus. Papa's already there. He's crossed over. And but see, Papa in heaven is doing what Jesus is all about.
There's only one word to describe. Yes.
See, God wants to come down to earth and touch His kids.
There's only one word to describe. Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty.
So this anointing was moving, right? If you're down here to worship, worship, leave alone. She's between God, but God's good. Let her worship by herself. God does things by herself. That's why you've got to figure it out too. This is holy moments for each person. Oh, I give you praise. So, the other day, the anointing was hitting me so hard. So I reached out to a friend I know in Florida that used to work with Benny Hinn. And I said, Joe, you got time to talk to me. I don't know what's happening. You gotta help me. I don't know what this is. Ah, it just was hitting me in waves like this. So I reached out to him. I said, Joe, what is this? And he said, it's revival breaking loose in the heart of man. I'm talking to him on my cell phone, here in this service, in my worship time. All of a sudden, within 2 to 5 minutes, he said, my God, it's here in my house, in my room, right now, on my life. It's hitting me. I got texts to prove that he texted me back. He said, my God, it won't lift from me. It's on my life. It's moving. Why? Because he wants to affect our life for eternity.
Lord God Almighty.
So the word of the Lord spoke to Joe in Florida. He said, tell the people that the anointing in this last revival is being poured out. And as it's being poured out, the anointing will continue to flow as long as we keep bringing people to be filled with that anointing.
Take us into the holy place.
In the last 3 days, people have invited people to come to the church when we're praying. The other day, Bruce invited a young man to come down to church, 20 some odd years old. He was touched by the power of God at age 16. He'd been doing everything under the sun, trying to find out where to fit, how to make it happen, and nothing was working right. It just seemed like it was tough, it was hard. He came in, I said, brother, you need to be touched by God. I said, you want to be touched by God? He said, yeah, I'd love to be touched by God. I said, okay. He came into the service, we turned the worship on, and within no time, the anointing of God began to touch him. It began to touch him and manifest in his life. He said, man, I've been looking all my life trying to find this presence. And I finally got touched by that presence. This is what God is doing. He's moving. He's flowing. He's moving. And what the Lord has instructed me to do as we go into this next year is we're going to start being sensitive to that anointing. We're going to learn how to flow in that anointing because that anointing makes things easy. That anointing makes everything easy.
That's right, just sing on your own words.
There's some of you that are hungry. If you want to come, come. Because the Spirit of the Lord's moving in this house right now as we speak. You want to get in that anointing, just come. Just begin to get in that, into that anointing. Get into that anointing. Psalmist David said, oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. God's looking for people that want to be touched by his presence.
A generation of people.
I give you praise, Father God. I give you glory. I give you honor. I give you glory. I give you honor, I give you praise for that anointing.
Oh,
man. Do you notice that some of them are sensing more of that anointing? Why? They're sensitive to that presence. Are you feeling them waves, sister? It just intensifies. Why is she feeling it? What's so special about her? Because she's hungry. The more hungry you are, the more the anointing's going to move. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got to repent. We've got to change our ways. We've got, revival is breaking loose. He has manifested, and we're more concerned about other things in our life than getting into his presence and letting God touch our lives.
Holy, God Almighty.
Go to that song, Healing Rain. It might be on that other set. Glory to God. Now watch what the anointing does. Some of you down here, you'll know what I'm talking about. Just turn it up.
Healing rain. It's falling down.
Oh, I praise you.
Healing rain is falling down.
You say, how do you get in that presence? You just worship Him.
Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain falling down. Worship the Father.
Healing rain is
falling down. Healing rain is falling down.
I'm not
afraid. Because how many know when the anointing shows up, you're afraid?
Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain is falling down.
Faith is rising.
Not afraid.
Hey.
Not afraid.
Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain is falling down. I'm not afraid.
Not afraid.
Healing rain is falling down. Falling down.
I'm not afraid.
I'm not afraid.
Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain is falling down.
I'm not afraid.
I'm not afraid.
Healing rain is falling down.
Falling down,
healing rain is falling down.
Not afraid, not afraid.
Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain is falling down. Not afraid. I'm not afraid. Falling down.
Not
afraid.
Not afraid.
Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain is falling.
Who is it in here that has a heaviness on them right now? I'm sensing that right now by the Spirit. There's a heaviness on somebody right in this room. If that's you, I want you to come. Come on, everybody just stand up in His presence. Would you do that? Come on, just stand up. Come on, just stand up. If you have a heaviness over your life, I want you to come right now. You got a heaviness, just come. Come on. Come on, if that's you, just come by the power of God. Just come. Come in the name of Jesus. Now watch the anointing when this word majesty.
Ah. Grace has found me just as I am. Empty hand, yes. But a love and we're singing
majesty.
We're singing
majesty.
Forever.
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 Glory to God. Forever.
We're singing
majesty,
majesty.
Oh, I love
your grace.
Your grace is on me just as I am.
Empty handed, but now in your hands. We're singing.
Father, teach us the way. Father, teach us the way of your anointing. teach us the way of your anointing. Reveal secrets that only you know. Reveal secrets that only you know, Father. Reveal secrets only you know, Father.
Majesty.
Let me just tell you what the word of the Lord just came to me and said. Many of you are looking what other people are doing, and you're trying to pattern your life after what they're doing instead of pattern your life after what God wants done. Because you know, is God successful? Is God successful? Very. Does God lack anything? Nothing. Nothing. And He created every single one in this place. He makes it flow easy. We make it flow hard. He makes it flow easy when we pattern our life after what God wants. He said He's coming back for a bride. Anybody ever been to a wedding? Man, when that bride comes down that aisle, that bride looks just spectacular. Just a knockout. Why? Because she's given herself to somebody that they love. I mean, know that God's coming for a people that's looking for Him. God's coming for a people that wants to give their life and say, Lord, here I am. I give to you.
Jesus.
I give you my life.
Our comfort. Our peace.
Go back to that one song, Holy. Well, I give you praise. Now, one thing that I've learned and learning that the more that you continue listen to a song, you know, see, a lot of people say, well, don't you have anything new? Why would you want anything new when you get a pattern? See, God is very order. He's very orderly. Do you know when you come into praise and worship consistently, do you know He'll meet you consistently? I think the other day, it was Wednesday, I came into prayers, praise and worship, and doing the same thing we're doing here. It was 4 hours went by like it was 5 minutes. But you know one thing I found out? Every crooked place in my life that I come across, every mountain that I'm faced with, God supernaturally makes things happen for me and makes it work. Some of you are waiting on God to move. God's already moving. If you want Him to move, then you've got to step forward and you say, Lord, I want to go deeper. I'm not happy where I'm at. Because some of you aren't happy where you're at. It's because you're choosing your way, your life, instead of choosing what God wants. And God's trying to help you make it easy, guys, gals. Why? The more that you worship Him, the easier things begin to come. Because the devil has to leave in this presence that we're talking about.
Comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. Only one word. God Almighty, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty.
Oh, I give you praise for that spirit.
One word comes to mind.
Oh, I love you, Father.
There's only one word to describe, and only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe,
just one, and only one word comes to mind.
There's only one word to describe,
and only one word comes to mind.
There's only one word to
place tonight. Purify our
Father, affect us. Touch us for eternity down here on this earth. Touch us. Touch us. Touch us by your power. Touch us by your anointing. Touch us by your anointing. Touch us by your spirit, Father God. Touch us by your power. Touch us by your glory. Touch us, Father God. I give you praise. Oh, I give you glory. 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 A generation of people. Oh, I give you praise, Jesus.
We know your
I give you praise, Spirit of God. I give you praise, Spirit of God. I give you praise, Spirit of God. I give you glory, give you honor. Oh, I worship your presence. I worship your presence. Thank you, Father God. 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 I worship your presence. Oh, I bless you. I give you glory. Thank you for your presence.
Holy, holy, holy. God Almighty, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty.
Oh, I worship you, Father God. I worship you, Father God. I worship you, Father God. Oh, I give you praise, Father God. I give you praise, Father. I give you praise. How many know that it takes time to get in the presence of God? The reason why many of us don't stay in the presence of God and don't get touched by Him is because we don't stay in it long enough. You know, we're used to going through McDonald's and getting it instantly and being done and going our way. But sometimes it takes time for the presence of God to begin to move because there's barriers, there's things in our life that every one of us are walking through because of what we've been choosing. But see, when God begins to move, God is beginning to draw us, then we have to learn to choose different.
There are cries of adoration from every nation.
Turn up. Glory to God. Thank you for that anointing falling in this place, Father God. You're welcome to move how way you see fit. Anointing of God, you can rain down in this place. Because remember, it's your place. Wow. My God, my God, my God. My God, my God.
Holy, holy, holy. Worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
Sing with me.
Turn up. Holy, holy, holy. Come on, church, just worship Him, would you? Come on, just worship Him. Come on, just give Him your best tonight. Would you do that? Come on, do it by faith tonight.
Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Redemption angels bow. Redeem, worship you now. Holy, holy, holy
you for the anointing. I thank you for the anointing. I thank you for the anointing.
Look, I can hear the sound of heaven, like the sound of many waters. Friends, it's the sound of worship, and it's coming from the throne. There are cries of adoration. Every nation, to bless the voice of glory known in holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
Oh, I thank you for the anointing.
The message still's bound. Redeem, we worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Redeemed, the angels bow. Redeemed, worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy.
Oh, be glorified in this house, Lord. Be glorified in this house, Lord. Be glorified in this house, Lord. Oh, you have permission to move in this place. You have permission to fall, Holy Ghost.
Message that says, shells bound, redeemed, worship you now. Holy, 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 holy,
praise for your anointing in this place. I give you praise for the anointing. I give you praise. I worship your anointing. Oh, I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you glory. Oh, I magnify your name, Jesus.
Sit those angels. Redeem. We worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy,
love you, Father. Oh, we love you, Father. Oh, we love you, Father. Oh, Father. Father, show them how much you love them. Father, show them how much you care. Father, show them. Show them, Lord. Show them, Father God. Show them, Father. Show them, Father. Show them how much you love them. Show them, Lord. Oh, Father God, you're a good God. You do good things to your people. We love your presence. We love your presence. We love your presence. We love your anointing. We love your spirit in this place, Father God. We glorify your name. We glorify your name. We glorify your name. We glorify your name. We just give you praise. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. We give you praise.
Human rain is
falling down.
Human rain is falling down. Healing rain is falling down. Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain is falling down. Healing rain is falling down. Not afraid. I'm not afraid. Healing rain is falling down. Healing rain is falling down.
Faith is rising.
I'm not afraid. Healing rain is falling down. Healing rain is falling down. Falling down, healing rain is falling down.
In the presence of
majesty. Your grace is found just as I am. Empty-handed, but I'm in your hands. We're singing.
Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. This is your church where you abode. This is your place. This is your place. There's no place like it. There's no place like it. Father, I love you so much. I love you so much. Thank you that I'm going to spend eternity with you. Thank you, Father, that I'm going to spend eternity with you. Thank you so much. 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 Oh, we bless your presence. We bless your presence. We bless your presence. We bless your presence. Go back to that song, Holy. Oh, we bless your presence. Now you watch, the anointing intensifies. The more you just continue to get in the presence and begin to worship. Turn it down just a little bit. Just watch what the presence of God. Some of you in your seats are experiencing a manifestation of his glory like you've never experienced. Because his anointing's getting stronger. Why? Because we continue to go back into that atmosphere. Why do you think Satan thought that he was lifted up? He thought he could have all that he wanted. But he had no business drawing attention to himself. He should have been giving all the glory to God. Because whenever you give glory to God, he will rain down over your life. Oh, I give you praise for that anointing in this place. I give you praise for that anointing in the place.
Just one look on your face.
Oh, I give you praise. Can we just all come down to the altars and just begin to worship him? Come on, just come on down to the altar and let's worship his presence tonight. Come on, let the Spirit of God begin to move in this place. Come on, just come around the altars. Oh, I give you praise. I give you glory. I give you honor. Just begin to spend time in His presence. If you don't know what to do, just worship and sing the songs. Oh, I give you praise for your anointing. I just give you praise for your anointing. I just give you praise for your anointing. I just give you praise for your anointing. Oh, I give you praise. Oh, let it be heavy in this house, Lord. Let that anointing be so heavy in this house. Let it be so heavy in this house.
And only one word comes to my mind.
Yes,
there's only one word to describe. Only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. Holy, holy.
I give you praise. I give you praise for the Lord.
Lord God Almighty. Holy,
anointing's increasing right now as we speak. That anointing's intensifying right now as we speak. I give you praise for that anointing. I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you
praise. And only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. There's only one word to describe, and only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe, and only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe. Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty.
I give you praise for that anointing. There is no one like you. You are holy, holy. God Almighty, holy, holy. Holy Ghost, you are so welcome in this place. One more time, Michael, go back to it. The anointing's just intensifying as we begin to worship Him. Now as we go back into the anointing of the Lord, go back into this presence of this, in this one. When we get in here, I want you to begin to ask Him for things that you need, and He'll begin to manifest those things that you've been wanting. Just begin to talk to Him and begin as we go back into this place. Touch Him. Father, I just want to love you all the days of my life. I just want to love you all the days of my life. I just want to love you all the days of my life. I just want to love you all the days of my life.
Just want to look on your face. Just one glance of your eyes.
I give you praise for answers right now, Father God. I just give you praise for answers.
Take me into a holy place.
Oh, glory to God.
And only one word comes to mind.
There's only one word to describe. Only one word comes to mind. There's only one word to describe.
There's only one word to
know you have a call of God on your life? You know that? What's that anointing? Watch it. What's that anointing? What's that anointing? What's that anointing? I give you praise. I thank you. Father, I just thank you for your presence, oh God. I thank you, Lord, that you're plotting his life out right now, Father. I thank you, Father, that you know his plans. You know every direction his life is to be. Lord, move upon it. Show him things to come.
Take us into the holy place.
Father, every weight, every situation that
take
is confronted, Thank you for that call. Oh, I give you praise. 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 I give you praise. I give you praise.
There is no one like you. You are holy, holy. There is no
Michael, just take it down softly. We're in the presence of God here tonight. I never want to leave opportunity.
That's right. Just sing out your own words.
If you're here tonight, you're not in the place where you need to be with God tonight. I want to give that opportunity, to give that to you. That tonight, if you're not born again, don't have Jesus as your Savior. Today is the day, the Bible says, of salvation. He wants you to come back into his body of believers. He wants to be in your life. He wants to be a part of what you do, where you go. If you're here today and you say, Pastor, would you help me get back to where I need to be so that I can be born again? Anybody lift up, lifted hand? Anybody at all? Sound of my voice. Anybody at all? Anybody at all? Hallelujah. You're here tonight and maybe you need to be rededicate your life. Maybe you went the wrong direction. Because I want you to know the world's pulling heavy right now, guys. The world is pulling very, 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 very heavy. The devil is that third voice that's trying to speak to many of us right now, and we've got to be able to be equipped to hear the right voice. We've got to be equipped to hear the right voice. If you're here today and you say, Pastor, I need to recommit my life to Christ, I want you to lift your hand. Anybody in this place say, Pastor, that's me. Yeah, thank you. Anybody else? Anybody else? I give you praise. I give you glory and give you honor. Maybe you're here tonight and you say, Pastor, I need to be filled with the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in tongues. It was like 2-3 weeks ago, we had over 10 teenagers get filled with the Holy Ghost. I mean, the move of God. I'm telling you, this move of God that's happening, it's moving mightily, and it's going to continue to grow. It's going to continue to flow. And those that's going to get in it are going to get in it. Those that don't want to get in it, just let them go on. Just keep focusing on what God wants. Why? Because he's changing eternity for many of us right now. You know, tonight, you changed the course of your life because of what you did tonight. Do you know there's things that are broke off of people's life because the devil was trying to plot some things out for each and every one of your lives, and some of them things were broken tonight because you allowed God to come in and begin to move in your life. And that's how I have dealt for the 55 years that I've been around. As I go back in this present, I was 12 years old when I got born again. My family didn't go to church. Does that sound like anybody? My mom and dad, you know, I went with the church with the neighbor, and I got born again. And I started listening to the Word of God and listening to the Word of God, and the God began to calm my heart and said, I want to use you. I remember times I'd be in Assembly God church, and I'd be worshiping the Lord, and I'd be singing in tongues. And I remember some of these little old ladies would come up and say, my God, would you do that more? I've never heard someone pray in tongues like that. Why? I just wanted God to use me. That's all I wanted. And then there were some teenagers that didn't like me because God began to bless me and things began to happen for me, and they got jealous, just like everybody else, right? Isn't that the way it works? But I just stayed in it. Why? Because I knew God would help me. All right? If you're here and you need to recommit your life, or you need to be born again, I want you to come right down here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anybody else? Anybody else? Glory to God. What do you want with your life, brother? It's up to you. You know, there's come a time that it's going to be hard to try to find God because, you know, he's chasing after you, but you've got to chase after him. Let me show you what I'm talking about. We were in praise and worship, and we were in prayer one day, and we were in here, and we put on some music, and I mean the Spirit of God lifted. Wasn't that right, Leon? The presence of God lifted. It left. And you know what the word of the Lord came to me? He said, there's going to come a time you're going to have to worship me by faith, not by feeling. Because remember, everybody else has already your path lined out. You know, friends are trying to influence you right now to go and do what they want to do. You know, there are teenagers today that have died prematurely because of a dare that somebody else tried to get you to do. And I want to tell you something. The only thing that is going to help you in this next generation is you've got to be mentored. You've got to be planted. You've got to get under some ministry somewhere that can help you and teach you the way of the Spirit. Let's take care of it. Say, Father, I'm sorry. Would you forgive me? Jesus, cover me in your blood. Holy Spirit, come upon me. I believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. I believe that I've made a confession, and I receive right now with my heart, right now, right now. There's that anointing. There's that anointing. There's that anointing. I give you praise. 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 Ah, there it is. Man, that's heavy now. Go. 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 You feel that? My God. See what happens when you stay in the presence of God. You're aware of the anointing. See, again, so many times we want to get in a rush. Do you understand what I'm talking about? You never get in a rush with God. You take your time with God. You take your time with God. Why? You don't know what God wants to do for you until you get in his presence. I don't know about you guys, but I'm telling you, I'm looking forward to tomorrow night. This is going to be more what's going to go on. Why? I want God to move in 2016 like I've never seen Him move. I want the anointing to touch red, yellow, black, and white. I want the anointing to touch teenagers that are on dope and on drugs, addictions. I want them to be touched by the power of God. Why? Because we get into this fire and this anointing, nothing can stop it, guys. Nothing can stop it. Nothing can stop it. Nothing can stop it. Nothing can stop it. There are voices that some of you are hearing right now that you have no business listening to that voice. You have no business listening to that voice. Why? Because you've got to be trained. Okay? Because how many of every one of us want to feel good? Right? Come on, girls, be honest with me. How many would like to have a good boyfriend to help you feel good? Yeah? You know you would. All right? But would you want the wrong boyfriend? Just because the package looks good doesn't mean the inside's good. Is that not right? That's why you got to have discernment. That's why you got to hear the voice of God. That's why you got to know. Why? Because, man, when you're in a relationship, man, it's just awesome. And I want to tell you something. God is moving and God is touching people. How many tonight honestly felt the presence of God? Come on, lift your hand up. Okay? How many feel different? Do you notice that I didn't touch anybody? Do you notice all I did was lead? All right? My job is to lead. My job is to help you, so that you're more aware of the presence of God. Okay? This is just the beginning, guys, of 2016. Just the beginning. Man, I wonder what He's going to do next. I don't know, but I'm going to be in the presence and find out, because you know what? I find out that He makes everything work for me. He makes everything flow for me. He brings jobs to me. He blesses me. He watches over me. I'm telling you, just great things are happening. Amen? Glory to God. Well, we're here tonight. It's time to give. If you came tonight that you're ready to give tonight, let's just love on the Lord with our giving. Would you do that tonight? Heavenly Father, we are so privileged. We are so privileged. We are so privileged to be here in Your presence. And Father, tonight, would You take every gift, every seed, every manifestation that belongs to You, Father, would You take it into Your bosom, Lord, and would You bless it, and would You accept it, Father God? Would You begin to break it and multiply it, Father God? Father, we thank You that tonight, Lord, that the enemy's assignment has been aborted tonight, Father God, just as the devil has instrumentally orchestrated aborting babies. So tonight, God instrumentally begin to abort assignments of the enemy in Jesus' name tonight. I thank You, Father God, that Satan's power has no dominion. I thank You, Father God, that the devil has no authority to begin to follow anybody home and to try to target anybody in any way, shape, or form, Father God. Father, we ask that we put angels of watch over Your body, over Your people, over Your young people, over Your children, over the moms and dads and grandmas and grandpa. And Father, we thank You that no harm will come nigh their dwelling. And Father, we commit our lives into Your hands, because You're the one that does a great job of taking care of Your people. So Father, we thank You that You will always be there for us, You will always help us in our time of need. And Father, I'm reminded, Father God, that as we leave this place, Father God, your word declares that everyone that came in was blessed. And Father, and I speak blessings, every one of them, as they leave this place tonight. And we give you praise and honor and glory. And everyone in agreement said, God bless you. See you Sunday. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus.